everyone. Chapter 2, whole numbers. We have already discussed the properties of addition, subtraction. Today we are going to discuss the properties of multiplications. The same properties as we have discussed. Now we have to find whether these properties will be applicable on multiplication or not. The first property we have done in addition as well in subtraction was closure property. Now closure property says that if we multiply here, because we are going to discuss under multiplication, if we multiply any two of the whole numbers, the product which will come will be a whole number. So 2 and 3 both are whole number, and after multiplication 2, 3 is a 6. I think 6 is also a whole number. So that means a closure property is true for multiplication. When we multiply 2 of whole number, the product that is going to come after multiplication will be a whole number. Absolutely true for multiplication. Next, commutative property states that if we change the order A multiplied by B or B multiplied by A, the product which is going to come will remain the same. For example, I have taken the two digits 3, 4 and 4, 3. So 3, 4 is a 12 and 4, 3 is a 12. Means both the products are same. That means commutative property is true for multiplication. Both the properties exist for multiplication. Third property, associative property says if there are more than two numbers, say 3 or 4, like I've taken 3 multiplied by 4 multiplied by 2. Here also 3 multiplied by 4 into. Now, in that case, if there are 3 or more than 3 numbers, what you will do? Firstly, we will take any two of the number. Let's suppose here I've taken 3 and 4 first, but here I've taken 4 and 2 first. Let's carry on with the multiplication. 3, 4 is a 12. Multiply by 2. 12, 2 is a 24. Here, instead of taking 3 and 4 first, here I've taken 4, 2. So 3 will come as it is. 4, 2 is a 8. And 8, 3 is a 24. Means, in either of the way, the product which is coming at the end is same. So that means associative property is true for multiplication. Next property is multiplicative identity. In addition, we have the name was additive identity. In subtraction, it was subtractive identity. But in multiplication, it will become multiplicative identity. Remember, in addition, we have such that number which is not going to change the identity of that particular, and that was 0. Additive identity was 0, subtractive identity was also 0. But with which number? With which number any of the digit will be multiplied so that it will remain same? I mean to say, if I'm going to take the example 6. 6 should be multiplied with which digit so that it will remain 6 only? It is 1. So that means a multiplicative identity is 1. We can take one more example. Let's suppose I have taken 3. So 3, if 3 is multiplied with 1, it will remain 3. This is called multiplicative identity, and multiplicative identity is 1. Next, one more property of under multiplication is zero property. If one of the factor is 0, let's suppose if 6 is multiplied by 0, if one of the factor is 0, the final product will definitely be 0. This is a new property under multiplication. If one of the, like 0 multiplied by 3, that is also 0. If one of the factor is 0, the product will be 0. This is something new under multiplication. And the last property is distributive property. Very, very important, because half of the exercise is based on distributive property. And something new under multiplication, because we have not studied distributive property under addition and subtraction. It is only under multiplication. So let me explain you in detail.